Guys, all right to go? Morning, thanks very much for joining us for the daily update. First things first, there are 14,659 confirmed aggregate cases of coronavirus in Victoria. That's 394 more than our last update. I'm saddened to say that there have been 210 deaths due to this pandemic in Victoria. That is an additional 17 fatalities since our last update. They include two males in their 50s, four males in their 70s, four females and two males in their 80s, and two females and three males in their 90s. To each of those families, we send our sincere condolences, our sympathies, our best wishes. This will be an incredibly difficult time for them, and I want them to know that they are in our thoughts and prayers as we continue to do everything we possibly can to deal with this second wave and to get beyond it. 10 of those 17 deaths are linked to aged care outbreaks. There are 634 Victorians that are in hospital. 43 of those are receiving intensive care. 26 of those Victorians are on a ventilator. A total of 1,801,385 tests have been processed since the beginning of the pandemic. That is an increase of 41,416 on yesterday, so a massive testing effort. And again, many thanks firstly to all of those who are coming forward, even with the mildest of symptoms. And again, thank you to the very large team across laboratories, both public and private, who are processing those tests. Coming forward when you've got symptoms, even mild symptoms, to get tested, then isolating at home until you get your result, and then taking that result seriously and doing as you're asked over that 14-day period is incredibly important. It's central to this strategy working. And again, I thank the very large numbers of Victorians who are coming forward and getting tested. There are 2,758 cases with unknown source. That's an increase of 174 since yesterday, so that's 174 of those mystery cases, which are in many respects our biggest challenge. Even large numbers in known and contained outbreaks are to a certain extent less significant than the smaller number of cases where we simply can't find the circumstance or the point of origin. Where did that person get the virus from? They're the ones that are incredibly challenging from a containment point of view, and that's what's made fundamentally necessary these really very challenging settings, these very difficult decisions we've had to make to drive down movement and therefore drive down the number of cases. There are 994 healthcare workers who are active cases. There are 1,748 active cases connected to aged care settings, and the total number of active cases are 7,854 across Victoria. The regional metro split is essentially unchanged from yesterday, so around 500 cases in regional Victoria, that is those LGAs that are under the stage 3 settings, but I would make the point there are a couple of hundred cases that are still to be investigated by our coronavirus detectives, and as and when we can update you on that split, then of course we will. We're very grateful, of course, to every single Victorian, and I think it is a growing number of Victorians who are following the rules, doing the right thing. I don't want their quite amazing performance, their effort, to be in any way overshadowed or undermined by a smaller number of people who are doing the wrong thing. There's just a message for those people again. Not only is it the wrong thing to do for your family and every family, it's also the sort of behaviour that will mean this second wave goes longer than it should, lasts, these restrictions are in place for longer than they should be. And it's also a sure way to finish up getting fined, because Victoria Police and others are out there in force, and they have the penalties, the powers, and they have the absolute resolve and determination to enforce these rules. These rules are there for all of us, and no Victorian has the right to be able to say, oh, well, I think I can do something that no one else is allowed to do. You've got to follow these rules. They're incredibly important. They are central to this strategy working, driving down movement, driving down case numbers, and then getting to the other side of this second wave. So I want to congratulate and thank and just say how proud I am of all those Victorians who are doing it tough but following those rules. It's so, so important. To those who aren't, you've just got to make much better decisions, because even one person making the wrong decision can lead to chains of transmission where there are hundreds of other people who get this virus. That will put our stated objective further away. It'll make it harder to achieve those lower case numbers. It'll make it harder for all of us to get to the other side of this. So whether it's to protect your family, every family, whether it's to avoid a fine, or whether it's to get to the other side of this quicker, every Victorian has to do the right thing, and I'm so proud and grateful to all of those who are.